Yeah, he got along with us.
So doesn't he love our spirits?
No, he don't love everybody's spirits.
Hey, the scripture says that Psalms 5, it says his soul hateth. Remember that scripture?
Right.
Yeah, I can't remember what Psalms 5 something. It says that.
You got your Bible, man. Pull your Bible out. Yeah. Pull your sword out.
I think it's 5 and 11. It says, they that
hit me
violence
with
violence is so hated.
Hit me with some Book of Mormon scriptures. I want to hear some of that Mormon.
Right,
fire.
Man. Come on, man. What y'all out here for?
Here. Go ahead and hand me the copy of the Book of Mormon.
You're going to give it back to me, right?
Yeah.
He's going to get mad at me. He's like, oh, you can't have it now.
You're not worthy. So the key invitation that we give to people, since we don't try to force this on anyone, we just try to invite them to find out for themselves. It's actually found right at the end. It's in Moroni chapter 10, verses 3 through 5.
We'll bring that Moroni out.
So Moroni is the last prophet. His last of
read it.
You want me to read it?
Yeah,
read it.
Lift up your voice like a trumpet. I want to hear it.
So it says, behold, I would exhort you that when you shall read these things, if it be wisdom in God that you should read them, that you would remember how merciful the Lord hath been unto the children of men, from the creation of Adam, even down until the time that you shall receive these things and ponder in your hearts. And when you shall receive these things, I would exhort or invite you that you would ask God, the Eternal Father, in the name of Christ, if these things are not true. And if you shall ask with a sincere heart, with real intent, having faith in Christ, he will manifest the truth of it unto you by the power of the Holy Ghost. And by the power of the Holy Ghost, you made up the truth of all things. So our key invitation is to read the Book of Mormon, to ponder in your hearts in the message it contains, and then to pray about it, and to be willing to act on whatever answer God gives you.
So what if he gives me an answer no? What does that mean? Am I cursed?
Hey, actually,
well, what are you willing to act on?
Let's skip that. Let's get the second Ezra's of the sixth chapter. Talk about the children of Adam. Where is that at?
So that's Moroni chapter 10, verses 3 through 5.
Who's Moroni?
He is one of the last prophets here in the Americas.
Okay, I think I know a little bit about it.
Yeah.
I know who Steve Young is. That's all I know, Steve Young.
He was one of the football players, right?
So he's a direct ancestor of Brigham Young.
So yeah. Being Jehovah's Witness, you guys consider, are you prophets?
No, we're Mormons.
We're not Jehovah's Witness.
Oh,
okay. Hey, can I read
you? So are you prophets? Your prophets.
We're not prophets, seers, and revelators.
Paul said
like
we must all prophesy, did he not?
Yeah, like we prophesy, we preach.
Well, if you prophesy, that means you have. Yeah,
merely
prophet,
we're
right?
Messengers for God.
But what for what it? God?
For God,
Heavenly
Father.
What's his name?
Heavenly Father.
Elohim.
Elohim. Elohim. Elohim.
Do you believe those Jews over there are the real Jews?
I don't know.
I gotta get a scripture. You got a scripture now, we get a scripture. We're going to get 2 Ezra's 6th chapter. You guys read the Ezra's?
Yeah, we read King James Version.
Okay,
with
the
Book of Mormon.
That's good.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
54. After these, Adam also, whom thou made his Lord over all that creature.
Right, the Lord created Adam, right? Mm-hmm. Now don't all men come from Adam, right?
Yeah.
So read that, start that again.
After this, Adam also, whom thou made his Lord for all thy creatures, of him came we all, and the people also whom thou chosen.
Now, he said we all come from Adam, even the people whom the Lord have chosen, correct? It's what the prophet Ezra says it. Keep going.
All this have I spoken before thee, O Lord, because thou madest the world for our sakes.
Thou madest the world for our sakes. For that's the nation of Israel, correct? Right?
We're his children.
Go ahead, keep going.
As for the other people,
as for the other people, the other nations,
which also come of Adam,
which also come of Adam,
that hath said that there are nothing, be like unto spittle.
They are nothing.
But being like unto spittle, spit.
but that's why the Lord says in Matthew 15 and 24, what does that say? He said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. But he also said that, you read all the prophecies all through the Bible, that Israel was scattered amongst the four corners of the earth. So Israel scattered through the earth.
And that's actually part of the message of the Book of Mormon, is part of Israel was scattered here to the Americas, and that's their record.
Matthew's 10 and 5.
That, you know, that's in the book of 2 Ezra, how Israelites scattered in America. You know about that? The account in, what was that, 2 Ezra, the 14th chapter?
Yeah, I've read through it all before, but I don't remember all of it.
So you believe the Native Americans were Israelites?
Some of them, at least.
Yeah.
We don't know if all of them.
Are you an Israelite?
We know at least a part of them were.
You an Israelite? Oh, you're an elder?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, Elder Smith. Elder Smith. I'm just going to
show. No, we believe that, yes, Israel had been scattered once, and that we believe that as they come to know Jesus Christ for themselves, that they can be able to, really, Israel can be gathered back again.
So am I an Israelite?
What?
Am I an Israelite?
Well, yeah.
Have you done your family history?
Don't make me get the scriptures. The scripture says, get that, you know that Timothy says, Antitus says, avoid genealogies. Because genealogies lie to you, because there's a whole lot of adultery in there. Our women are whores.
That's right.
So you don't know where you came from.
Matthew 12:10-5. These 12 y'all shall I send forth and commanded them, saying, go not into the way of the Gentiles, and into any city of the Samaritans enter ye not, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
The lost sheep of the house of Israel. A lot of people, they love to say, like, I love everybody. You know that, I mean, that's really not true. You know what I'm saying?
He loves his people.
He loves it because it's all about Israel. That's the mystery of the scriptures. The Lord came to save Israel from their sins.
So I have a quick question for you. Where do you believe your spirit was before you were born?
It was with the Heavenly Father. Yeah, when a man dies, the spirit returns to the Heavenly Father.
What about everyone else here? Where was their spirit?
With the Heavenly Father. Exactly.
So does that not mean it gets all those children?
Well, yes, of course we're all God's children.
In the spirit world, there's divine.
But there's still division. The Lord created, get Matthew 25th chapter, 25 and 31.
We don't want a Bible bash here. We just want to...
This is what we do.
But contention is of the devil.
Contention? Well, hey. Paul said to contend for the gospel.
Yeah, Paul said...
There's different types of contentions. You know what I mean? So it's all about balance. There's a balance in the world.
Gospel. Paul, it says scriptures in Acts 18, I believe, that Paul was 17, that he daily argued with people in temple, whatever.
Yeah, well, we could talk about the scriptures, what we believe versus what you believe, and not have to want to kill you over it.
Here you go. This is
we can
Jude.
Be civilized, right?
The book of Jude says, beloved, when I gave all diligence to write unto you of the common salvation, it was needful for me to write unto you and exhort you that ye should earnestly contend for the faith which was once delivered unto the saints.
And that's why we're out here, because we were passionate about this. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Same with us. We believe that the Book of Mormon is the Word of God, the Bible also.
Y'all gonna die by fire. Or y'all probably die in the race wars. Or somewhere. Y'all gonna die, period. Y'all ain't gonna make it, because y'all ain't got to deal with nothing. Y'all ain't under the Lord, man, the real Lord. The real God of the Bible, man. Protect.
That is the
so y'all
God.
In trouble, man.
Hey, read that.
God of the Lord.
Read that, man.
You know, the last day it says it's gonna come forth false prophets, man. False prophets, man. Y'all have no wisdom, knowledge, nor understanding whatsoever. None.
So let me ask you a question. You said you did all your genealogies and stuff, right?
Not all of them.
So where did that take you back to? But you guys try to teach what? That you're all descendants of the nation of Israel?
No. That we're all descendants of Adam, and that being in the family of Adam, we can return to the
Father. I know Mormons are obsessed with genealogy, right?
Right.
They have like some of the top genealogy scholars in the world. They make you all take DNA tests too?
No.
Because genealogies doesn't seem like a very spiritual thing to me. Because this Bible says we know who the sons of God are by the Spirit. The Spirit, that Romans, the 8th chapter. Their spirit beareth witness, not their genealogy beareth witness. Because genealogies, like I said, nobody can trace their line. Nobody has records to go back 2,000, 3,000 years. Hey, but let me read this.
But Esau.
Let me get Matthew 25. Check this out.
Matthew 25:31. When the Son of Man shall come in his glory, all the holy angels with him.
Where is he coming from?
Heaven.
From heaven, where is heaven at? It's up there, right? Outer space. He's coming straight from outer space.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Then shall he sit upon a throne of glory, and before him shall be gathered all nations.
So before him, before the Son of Man, who's the Son of Man? The one you call Jesus Christ, right? All nations are going to be gathered before him. Continue.
He shall separate them.
He shall separate them. There's that separation again. Keep going.
One from another.
One from another.
As a shepherd divided the sheep from the goats.
Yeah, as a shepherd divided sheep from the goats, right? Because not everybody is a lost sheep of the house of Israel. Okay, keep going.
He shall set the sheep on his right hand.
And the sheep shall be set on the right. And the right represents righteousness. That's where you get the word right. Doing the right thing. okay? But the goats are going to be set on the left. Continue.
But the goats on the left.
Goats, like, you know who Esau is? You guys know who the biblical Edomites are?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, do you need to do any genealogies on Esau?
Not so much.
No? You're not really concerned with Esau?
I haven't done that myself, but I imagine it's been done.
You know, Esau's from where? Mount Seir, right? Well, Seir means hairy, hairy like a goat. Okay. Shayar.
I didn't get too much into genealogy myself.
Well, Esau is a very important character in the Bible. You know, you could be related to Esau. So, you know, you'd be proud of your heritage. You know what I'm saying? But Esau comes from Mount Seir, which is, Seir is related to the word, it means hairy, hairy like a goat. So, the left-hand side is dealing with Esau. So, Esau is like a goat. That's why his one of his favorite idols is Baphomet, the androgynous goat demon.
Who are the Edomites? Because you know the Obadiah, you're familiar with the book, another Obadiah?
Obadiah?
Yeah.
You know, let's get up Obadiah 18.
Yeah. Uh-oh. But really, the big key with what we do is, and the only reason I can say this is because I found out for myself, I've fulfilled the promise that God has given us that if we lack wisdom, we can ask of him and he'll let us know. And I know for myself that God has spoken to me. He's told me what is true, and he's told me that the Book of Mormon is true. And I know that you can find out for yourself, but you have to read, you have to diligently seek, and you have to be ready to.
Was Joseph Smith an Israelite?
Yes.
He was?
He was. He was descended from Joseph in Egypt. That was a prophecy.
He was descended from Joseph.
This is Revelation 9 and 15. Wow. And the four angels.
I never heard that before. I never heard that before. So that's,
you know, actually, Joseph talking about Ephraim?
Huh?
You know, actually, Joseph, when you say Joseph is actually talking about the tribe of Ephraim or whatever.
Ephraim, Ephraim come out of Joseph.
Puerto Ricans?
This actually scripture says Ephraim, I mean, Joseph is Ephraim.
Yeah, because Ephraim, because there was.
Because Joseph had the birthright, he had two tribes.
Yeah, he had two tribes came from Joseph.
Yeah, that's not talking about Todd Smith, whatever his name is.
Joseph Smith.
Yeah, he was descended from Ephraim.
I don't know. I don't know about Joseph Smith. Maybe Brigham Young. I don't know.
And the four angels were loose, which were prepared for an hour and a day and a month and a year for to slay the third part of men.
The third part of men. All right, because he didn't save them all. The third part got slain. Because you got three classifications of men, basic classifications, which was what? The sons of God.
Just Israelite.
The sons of the devil, which they know. Then you just got a regular old heathen, like, you know, the Moabites, Ammonites. Because you have one class of heathens. You got Moabites, Ammonites, Elamites. Those are just regular old heathens, Ishmaelites. But you got the super-duper heathen, which is who? Esau. Because it's the Hebrew Edomites. Which is, he's the spiritual successor to who? Cain. Right? And you go, Esau still exists, doesn't he? He still is walking to and fro on this earth.
Of course. Earth was given. Hey,
read that Obadiah 18.
I never seen an Israelite international banker.
Romans the ninth chapter said, as it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated. Ooh. It says that, doesn't it?
That's all
it is. Do some studying and research on Esau. Get on Google, type it.
I definitely will. But it was really nice to meet you.
In response, read the book of Mormon. Right, pray about it.
Yeah, that's that Freemason stuff. Oh, y'all's Freemasons. Is this a Freemason? What kind of rites and rituals y'all got going on? You can't discuss it. I understand. But wasn't Joseph Smith he brought some Freemasonry into Mormonism, didn't he?
He
didn't bring it in, but he was a Freemason.
But
it's not a part of our family.
What should be done to him? Since he was a Freemason, is he a righteous man?
Well, the Freemasons, they aren't a cult.
They're not a cult?
No.
But what, they worship in secret? And the Lord said, we do nothing in secret. He said, if you take your light and let your light so shine before men.
I had met, actually, a Freemason, and I asked him what they do, and
he's not gonna tell
you because you nobody, he ain't gonna come out and be honest with you. That's why.
He's a really good friend.
Well, it don't matter.
He
it don't
said
matter.
That
you're not part of them, man.
They're actually, they just meet and they become really better men in the community. Like,
there's Freemasons got secrets with other Freemasons.
What community?
Until you get higher up.
And what does the Lord have to say about this great community?
That's why
he said, love not the world, neither the things that are in it.
Each level is becoming more and more wiser.
So the community is of the devil. The hell with the community. Okay? The Lord is going to destroy the community. You know, you have like some called, well, yeah, by Al Barrett, the God of the community.
That's what I told y'all, man.
Will you all
thanks for the information.
The Book of Mormon.
I already read that. We're
gonna read it.
To it. Got no, absolutely no power to it.
Did you pray about it?
Of course, we pray about everything.
Pray about season, bro. Come on.
But I appreciate the copy though, because it's good to study things and then. Okay.
You're welcome. And we've actually got a bus to catch here in a little bit. It was really nice to meet you, but we really have to get going.
Don't forget,
it's fire
coming. Google
Wild
Esau.
Beast, fire.
We will.
Death. Race wars. Yeah. Class wars.
Nukes.
Thermonuclear missiles.
Just have to figure out what's true and what's not.
All right, bro. You see all the information we got out of? They told us that Joseph Smith claimed to be an Israelite. They told us that he admitted that Joseph Smith was a Freemason. You see that, right?
Yep.
Out of the that's why you got, instead of just straight going calling them devils right from the rip.
Yep.
You got to be deceitful, bro. You got to be nice to them.
Yep.
You got to milk that information out of them. You see what I'm saying? That's why.
We seduced them in a way.
Yeah, you got to seduce them. You know what I'm saying? You got to be smooth with it, boy. Yeah, you got to get them interested, bro.
Oh, really?
Because you got to be wiser than serpents, harmless as a dove. You know what I'm saying?
A lot of motherfuckers don't want you to argue. They don't want to argue, so you got to act all
right. You got to be nice.
Think about this.
And then you slowly get up in there. You know what I mean? That's how you do it.
They weren't ready to fight, man. Continue.
Right. Because you know, like, 5 years ago, 10 years ago, I would have just called them a bunch of Edomites. You're going into slavery. Cuz called them a faggot. You know, but now I'm a little wiser. Now I know how to... Even the Bible does say, Paul said, if at all possible, be peaceful with all men. We ain't got to sit, you know.
Especially
the devil. The devil's the one that's going to hurt you. They going back and they're reporting on what this happened. They have to report. You know what I mean?
Well, it's true.
The Bible, we told you to stay away from them.
Okay, now you're all over the internet.
Now you're making us look foolish.
Slay them.
Oh, they gonna come after us now, boy. Hey, man, we gotta praise you out, boss, from you outside for that one. No, it's been a minute. Usually the Mormons, we're not talking. We see them all the time. They usually always like, oh, we can't talk because they
do. Yeah, across the street and go, you know.
Them two must.
Yeah, right.
We hit them with that seducing spirit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They have some foul spirits on them. They're newly Edomites. Look, the higher levels, you know, that's why, look, the higher levels of Mormon church, they know they Edomites. They know it.
Yeah, yeah.
I heard there's an expert that came on to Tex Mars. You knew love no Tex Mars.
Yeah.
You know Tex Mars, he had this book called Codex Magicum.
Yeah.
It's a famous book on the occult where he exposing the occult.
Yeah.
He was one of the top guys going out years ago exposing the Illuminati and their symbolism. But he got a radio show every week. I used to listen to it. But one week he had a show, an expert on the Church of Mormon come on his show, and he said in the higher levels of the Mormon, they teach that they're Edomites. They got proof that in the records that proof that they descend from Esau. And you can tell those are straight up Edomites. You know what I'm saying? You can tell.
Just like the higher ups of the Jews too, they know they're Edomites too.
That's why I had a that's why you can tell my spirit was totally different. My spirit
totally is different.
Totally different. You know what I mean? That's why you know all white people ain't the same. That's proof right there. I ain't got no weird ass, goofy ass fucking spirit like that.
Yeah, goofy ass spirit. See, they're just nobodies. That's why they don't know shit.
Yeah, they don't know nothing. They're not gonna tell no guys like that, though.
Yeah, they're stupid. I ain't vulnerable.
They said they got proof that Joseph Smith was an Israelite. You know, some bullshit.
Okay.
See, and that's always something the devil to be all into the genealogies. That's a lack of faith right there. We don't need no genealogy. Well, the spirit bears witness that we the children of the Most High. No, the Mormons are obsessed with genealogy. They got some of They got vaults of records just upon records and records and records. Go look at it. Just Google Mormon and genealogies. They got some of the top genealogy scholars in the world working on that shit.
That's crazy. That's crazy.
And I heard it. They quickly can go back to Esau.
Esau.
Yo, Esau, you going into slavery, bitch. Now, I could have said that to me, but hey, that's too easy. That's too easy to do that. Oh, yeah. That's all good. Hey, we gave the scripture. We read the scripture and said there was nothing because there was just... We said it with a smile on our face.
Just spit.
And I don't think they was even... They were so stupid, they wouldn't even understand if we was calling it spit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That was beautiful, bro. You got crazy. Yeah, that's a... Right before we came out here, he's like, we don't know what we're going to get today.
Man, right.
The Lord gave us a little treat.
What gift we going to get today?
Man, every week we come out, we get treats, bro. The Lord giving us treats. First, he gave us the IUIC, even though that was a headache. It was beautiful. Last week, we had the Egyptology. It just don't end, bro. The Most High is marvelous in all his ways. Hey, let me get that script. Like some brute or something out here. Yeah, that's that bullshit. He put the whole bottle on. So you gotta take it easy, bro.
Psalms 139:14.
Oh, here go. I just look up the word wondrous. Psalm 72:18. Blessed be Yahweh, the power of Israel, who only doeth wondrous things.
Psalms 139:14.
What's that one that says that wondrous works? That's a here famous saying.
139:14. I will praise thee. For I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth right well.
Marvelous are thy works. Marvelous. Marvelous. The Lord is marvelous.
Marvelous, something like
that. My God damn!
Marvelous. That's what it's like. That's what power, man.
That's why when the Spirit hits you, your mind can belong. You know what I'm saying? When the Spirit hits you in the revelation, bro, your mind... How many times does our mind get blown when we get out here? That's why we believe in this.
Hey man, you know you're Edomite.
Esau.
Come here, come here. A biblical Edomite. Alright.
Alright, Esau. We just seen your cousins. They probably fucking, I ain't gonna say, I just had a bad visual. But them two weirdos is good. And they're not even real warm. You know, the real Mormons, they're supposed to have multiple wives, weren't they? Oh, Satan. Psalms 45:5. I will speak of the glorious honor of thy majesty and thy wondrous works. There's another one, though, go. Maybe it's not the word wondrous. It was another one. Marvelous, too. My brain's not working right now.